Hey guys, it's Melissa. Welcome to my office. We are here on the computer today in Silhouette Studio. I am going to give you 5 reasons that your setup for print and cut is giving you registration errors, and we are going to fix them. So let's launch Silhouette Studio and get right to it. These are the things that are going to cause you to have the biggest problems with print and cut. Okay, first things first, we need to make sure that our page setup is correct. There are so many settings here, it can be very confusing what to do. So let's say we are using a Cameo 5. So we want to make sure that our Cameo 5 is selected. I typically go with the one that says auto. Same thing with the feed type, same thing with the cutting mat. Media size here is where people get in trouble. Now, what we are going to do is we are not going to pick anything on media size other than printer. However, printer needs to be set up correctly, and this is key. So we are going to pick printer, but then immediately after we do that, we are going to go up to file and print page setup. Now I am on a Mac, so it may look a little bit different for you, but we need to make sure that if you are on a PC or you are on a different Mac operating system, you go into page setup. So do you see how here where this says format for any printer? That's a big no-no. You want to pick your exact printer. Look at all these printers I have, okay? These are not just, I don't have actually this many printers, but if you look closely, you will see that some are USB and some are Wi-Fi. So that's actually the same printer. It's just 2 different types of connections. So what you want to do is pick the actual printer that you are going to use. So let's say for this case, I am going to use my Epson ET2800. I actually have 2 of these eco tanks, but I'm going to pick this one for now. Then you want to pick the paper size that you're using. And you've got a lot of different options here. I am going to use letter size. Okay. Now we are all set. I can click OK. What that does is it makes sure that the printer that I have selected basically syncs with the page setup that I have here and the media size. So if you are picking anything else, if you are picking letter size, if you are picking A4, you are risking getting registration mark errors. So those are the big things here, right here, that you want to pick. Number 2, you need to turn on, or number 2, I should say like number probably 10 by this point, but you want to make sure that you turn on print border. Okay. The reason for this is there are certain types of paper, and this is going to be a little bit difficult for you to see. What I'm going to do actually is turn this all white. You have this red cut line here. That is the cut line border. Okay. That means the machine will not cut outside of that border. When you turn on the show print border, you get a gray border. Now, depending on the media that you're using, this gray border is going to move. So in some cases, it might be further in. The reason this is important is because when you turn on your registration marks, which we are going to do, I am just hitting M on my keyboard to turn them on. If you have your registration marks turned on and they fall outside of the safe print area, you are going to have an issue. For example, if your print page setup, if your print size, excuse me, paper size, comes over here, it's going to cut off the bottom or the horizontal part of this registration mark down here. And that is going to cause a registration error. All right, now we have the page set up. Now you saw that I just am toggling this on and off with M on my keyboard. Okay, you can also go to registration marks tab and turn them on. If you are new, my suggestion is to use the M tool. The reason is you are not tempted to change any of these other options down here, which are going to contribute to getting registration mark errors, especially if you're a beginner. So use M to turn these on, and don't be tempted to change any of these other things where you're not super familiar with. Now, if you come in here and let's say your registration marks are like this, or like this, and you're like, what is going on? If you're getting registration mark errors, click restore to default, and that will put them back where they were, and then stay out of this area for right now. Next thing, you need to make sure that your design that you are going to print and cut is A, set up correctly, and B, in the right area, Okay, so we are going to go to File Merge. I like File Merge because it brings the designs directly into the work area that I'm currently using. Now, these are all stickers. These are, I'm going to switch you over quickly. Let's see, give me 1 second here. Okay, so the reason that I like this is, the reason that I'm showing you this is because if you can find a bundle that has stickers, it's the designs themselves hopefully will be set up as sticker friendly. And you can see that this one, which I will link to, is set up specifically as stickers. I'm going to show you what that looks like and why that is so beneficial. So we are going to use this set. Again, it's from So Fancy. I will link to, I will tag that product so you can easily grab it. And I will also link to it in the description. So here are my designs. If you remember, we went to File Merge, and here we go. So I'm going to pick one of these. Let's just pick this one. It's cute. Okay, and I'm going to click OK. Now, it comes in here, and you can see, make it a little bit bigger, it already has a cut line around it. Now, I'm going to change the transparency so that you can see more closely that it also has a white border around it. This is set up specifically as a sticker, which is exactly why I'm recommending to, especially as a beginner, to go with something like a sticker bundle, because the products are, the designs are already intentionally set up this way. Really, really important. You don't need to worry about adding a white border. You don't need to worry about a bleed. You don't need to worry about any of that. It is done for you. Okay, what does that mean? What that means when we go to print and cut is that the cut line is already there. You don't need to do anything else. Okay, so this is a really good one to start with. Now, couple of things here. Again, this is going to mess up. This is probably like number 5 by now. This is going to mess up and give you a registration error if you do not follow this correctly. If your design is outside of the cutting area, it will not cut. If your design is in the hashed areas, whether it's, let's say it's like this, so it's inside the cutting area, it's inside the safe printing area. Unfortunately, it is in this register, this hashed area. I know it's not touching the registration marks, but it's in this area. You need to keep things away from there, okay? All right, now let's add a couple more. And we're going to do File Merge again, and we'll bring in another one. Again, these are all from the same set, so and they're super cute. And again, the reason that I like this is because they are already set up, so we can pull more designs in. Let's just bring another one. The other way you can do it is to literally just drag and drop. So I'll show you that method as well. All right, so we can just drag and drop these directly into Silhouette Studio. So we'll bring a few in here, okay? All right, so we've got these in here. I'm going to resize these down a little bit by scaling. Again, you need to be very, very careful. I know it is also very tempting to keep things extremely close together. This also tends to throw a registration mark error. So please give your stickers some space. Once you are more of an advanced user and you understand, you know, the intricacies of print and cut, then you can make decisions like, how many can I fit on a page? Can I nest? Can I adjust where the hash marks are? Can I give myself larger space? Yes. The answer to all of that is yes. However, now is not the time as a beginner. If you are having registration mark errors, we need to reset. We need to go back to basics, and these are the basics. Now, if you get stuck and you need help, you are welcome to reach out directly to me. I offer one-on-one personalized help, same-day support. I will get right back to you. I have troubleshooted thousands, probably, of print and cut issues, and we can fix them all. Pretty much guarantee you, you send me a couple of screenshots, I can tell you exactly what it is that is causing your registration mark errors. So when you are having registration mark errors, I want you to go back to these basics. Do these things. It's all about the setup and it's all about the settings. So you need to make sure that all of that stuff is top notch and exactly as it needs to be. And as you saw, there are a lot of different settings that can cause a mismatch or a registration mark error. Okay, I have lots of videos on print and cut on here on YouTube. I have even more on Silhouette U. I actually also have a full curriculum on print and cut on Silhouette U. So those come along with a membership, which obviously also includes the one-on-one personalized and same-day support. So I hope you join. I will throw up some links up in the description below, and I'll see you guys soon.